So in this lecture, we are going to discuss about the benefits of static testing. So let's start with the topic. So the first such benefit is with respect to efficiency. So in static testing, we can detect and correct defects more efficiently. Let's see with an example how it is possible. So this is a software development lifecycle where you have a requirement phase, then you have a system requirement, global design, detailed design, and finally the implementation stage. Let's take an example that you start directly with the dynamic testing and not with the static testing. That means in this stage only you can perform the testing. And if you find any defects in the code due to dynamic testing, then you have to do the analysis. And there is a possibility, since the requirement was wrong, your global design was wrong, your detailed design was wrong, and as a result, your implementation was wrong. In this case, first you have to change or you have to correct your requirement, which will result in correction of your global design, detailed design, and finally the implementation. So now you can see that since you have found the defect here, you have to change certain things in these four stages. Whereas, now if you come to the static testing, because static testing will be performed before the dynamic testing starts. So now you will do a testing in requirement phase itself, and if you find any defect, then you will fix it here itself, and then your global design will be correct, your detailed design will be correct, and your implementation will also be correct. So that way, finding defects in a static testing is a more efficient way, because you are finding the defect in one stage and you are changing the requirement or document in one stage itself, because you are performing the testing early in the lifecycle. So this is all about the first point. The second point is with respect to the identification of defects. So in static testing, you can identify defects that are not easily found by the dynamic testing. For an example, the indentation problem. So this particular thing is a problem with respect to the Mishra guidelines, wherein they tell if you write a code, then you have to follow the indentation. But such type of defect you cannot find in a dynamic testing, because this is not a functionality failure, whereas it is with respect to the guideline failure. So such type of defects you cannot find when you are performing a static, when you are performing a dynamic testing. So only static testing can find such type of defects. Now coming to the third point, that is prevention of defects. So when we perform static testing, we will prevent defect going to the design phase or the coding phase, because we will find the defects early itself. For an example, if the customer has given you this requirement, which we have already seen, that for web page, when the login details is given, the next page shall load in few milliseconds, and if the login details are not correct, then show a pop-up. Suppose this requirement was given and directly it went to the implementation stage. Then in the implementation stage, people will ask this question: how much time it will take to load the next page, what will be the content of next page, and what will be the pop-up content. And then it has to go through complete stage, and then we have to get this answer. Whereas if you perform a static testing in the requirement phase itself, you will clarify all these doubts. So that way you will prevent any such type of defects which can come to the design phase or to the coding phase. And such particular things will also result in productivity, because everything you are clearing it in the first stage itself, and then all the process will run smoothly. So with respect to productivity, what we have to say is it will increase the development productivity, because in the coding phase you don't have to wait for the inputs. Yeah, so these were the four points. Like, it will increase the efficiency, it will help you in identifying defects which you cannot find in dynamic testing, it will prevent defect from passing to the design phase or the coding phase, and then it will also help you in increasing the productivity. Now let's see some more points with respect to the benefits of static testing. So the development cost. So when you are performing static testing, you will reduce the development cost and time. Similarly, testing cost also. So if you perform a static testing on testing documents, then you will reduce the testing cost and time. Let's see how. So this is the same example. So if you find defect here, then you need only one resource, and in only one stage you have to fix the defect. So that way your decreasing the time to fix the defect, and also you are decreasing the cost because less resources available. Whereas if you find defect here, then you have to change the defect in three places, three resources will be available and more time will be consumed. So that is what it all about, development cost and testing cost. So if, with respect to static testing, the cost will reduce. Now coming to the total cost. So obviously if development cost reduces, testing cost reduces, then the total cost will also reduce. So the cost of quality over the software lifetime will reduce. So since you are finding most of the defects during your development activity itself, then when the product is in the maintenance stage, you will not find such defects. And that way you are saving time and cost throughout the software development life cycle. And last point is with respect to the communication. Because the testers are getting involved early in the software development life cycle, so the communication will be better now. So it will improve the communication between team members. Okay. So these were the points with respect to static testing. And now I will just read out this line, so which will be like more, will provide you more clarity regarding the static testing. Static testing technique provides a variety of benefits when applied early in the software development lifecycle. Static testing enables the early detection of defects before dynamic testing is performed. So before we perform the dynamic testing, we can find many defects which will be helpful in order to reduce the cost, time, efficiency, productivity and all other stuff. So that is it from this particular topic, and I will see you with my next video. Until then, happy testing.